Babe, you promised we were gonna get away.
You know I want to. I can't. Maybe in a couple years.
You're not gonna be thankful when you're 50 and waste your life in a cubicle. You don't feel the same way, I see. All right, badass. Come on, you're the only thing keeping me here. Come on, I'm done losing the rat race.
There are things I want in life, and my job helps me get those things.
Yeah.
Come on, keep an eye.
You've never been there. There's a calm that comes over you. The water.
What?
We could be the ones. We could be the ones that got away.
What about the mortgage? I just refinanced. And I have my student loans. You know how important this job is.
Look at your real love's here. You can box with him.
And we want jobs here.
You know he's the 38th richest man in the world?
Yeah, well, if that's rich, then I don't want to be rich.
Stop.
It's really hard to get it down, but our companies are making huge profits.
Which of you become ignorant or apathetic?
I mean, we can do things, you know.
I don't know.
Literally,
and I don't care.
Only half cheaper, but maybe even a three-quarter.
Oh, come on! That was a joke. A good one.
Just hope that I can always live up to it. I believe I can, because not knowingly I've ever done anything that's been dishonest.
Left your key card on your desk again, huh? I got you.
Thanks.
So, any plans for the 4th?
No plans. I'm just gonna enjoy the holiday weekend. Bet you can't wait to get out of here.
No, working a double shift. I can use the holiday pay.
The kids all right?
Yeah, they're fine.
Well, what's with the long face then?
Oh, this is you. There you go.
Okay.
If you need to talk, I'm here.
What's wrong?
Jane? Something terrible's happened.
What?
This can't be easy to hear, but they found Mike dead this morning, out front.
What? How?
Apparently suicide. He threw himself on the top of the building.
My God.
I'm sorry. Thank you.
You okay? I'm so sorry, Jean. They already packed all of Mike's stuff. I can't believe they move so fast. What do you expect?
Everyone, can you
gather around?
As soon as I heard the very distressing news, I wanted to be here in person with you all at this very difficult time. We all have a huge hole in our heart this morning, especially me. Because not only was Mike my employee, he was also my friend. We are like a family here. We must all stick together. As Winston Churchill said, success is not final. Failure is not fatal. It's the courage to continue that counts. We will continue Mike's great work. God bless you all. God bless Mike. Jane, a word.
Oh, of course.
God. How could a man? Oh. It's interesting, isn't it? This must have been the last view that he had before he jumped off the building. You knew him well, didn't you?
Yes, sir.
What was his mindset?
That's just the thing. I never thought Mike would be capable of something like this.
Well, we never know what we're capable of. You know, it seems to me, Jane, you are the ideal candidate to take over Mike's position.
Hadn't even occurred to me.
Oh, please, don't be coy with me. This is one great opportunity. Does that excite you?
With all due respect, sir, it's difficult to be excited about anything right now.
Very well. Remember, time waits for no man.
Sorry. I don't know what to say.
I didn't know who else to call. I don't understand. Mike would have never...
What can I do for you?
Mike has some photos on his desk of him and the kids.
I just can't come to the office and face everyone. Do you mind getting them for me, please? I will grab every photo I see and make sure you get them right away. I can bring them over to you, too, if you want some company. Pam, if there's anything else that we can do, me or Ray, please don't hesitate to ask us. We're here for you, okay?
Thank you, Jane.
it. Colleen, you can't just barge in here like that.
I know. I'm sorry. I come in peace.
You gotta eat, babe. Jane.
Thank you. I'll eat it.
We have secrets between us now? You're learning the game.
I didn't think he even liked Mike.
If you think Taft or anybody here cares about anything but their own job, you're nuts. I want his job and he wants Galt's job.
Did you know what Mike was working on? What he was into?
Into?
Yeah.
What was he into? What is it you think we do here, cure cancer? I'm not quite sure what you're getting at.
What is he doing?
Let me give you the same advice I got when I started here. The only way a woman is gonna get ahead in this boys' club is to keep her head down and be the biggest bitch on the block. Period.
God, who said that?
You did.
This doesn't make sense. Of all people.
You don't think Mike was a suicidal type?
I don't know what the suicidal type is, but it wasn't Mike.
Then why'd he do it?
I found this tape to the bottom of Mike's desk.
What is that?
Financial data that implicates someone in this company of major embezzlement. The large pension securities accounts have been completely depleted. The amount missing is staggering.
Stop. I need you to double check the files and be absolutely certain before you make any accusations.
I already have. But I'll do it again if you want.
Jane, let's keep this between us. I don't need to tell you how serious this is.
What are we gonna do if it's true?
If you actually have something, there are procedures. We'll wait until the office is empty and we'll call the SEC. Together. But I need the proof.
Okay. I'll go get your proof.
Thank you.
You're not bailing out on happy hour again, are you?
I just have to finish this stuff up. Couple more hours.
You need a drink. We all do.
I can't. Can you babysit Ray for me until I get there?
Are you sure? You've seen me when I drink.
Then behave yourself and be a good girl.
Are you serious with this?
I really can't come. I'm sorry.
Okay, just call me when you finish up.
I will.
Well,
Mike was onto something. Big. Bad. You know, illegal.
Okay. Get everything ready for a formal review, and I'll have someone here in 30 minutes. It'll be okay. Unfortunately, the problem has spread. No, it's beyond my control. I'll be in the lobby.
Hey, babe. How you feeling?
I thought I knew him. It's just crazy to think how someone can be here one day and the next day they're gone just like that.
I know. I'm sorry, babe. I love you.
Can I do anything?
No. I don't know.
Do you want me to come and get you? I will come and get you right now.
No. Please don't do that. I have to do this on my own.
You gotta do what?
It's nothing to worry about. Anyway, you're gonna be proud of me.
I'm always proud of you.
I wanna take care of you.
I'm gonna be fine, I promise. Colleen's on her way over.
Oh. Okay.
I love you, Ray.
I love you.
It's over with. We need to see the surveillance room.
Surveillance room?
Anybody on duty besides you tonight?
It's okay, Lomani's with me. Come on, Frank, let's go upstairs. Let's not waste time.
Anybody else on duty tonight?
No. Why do you ask?
Let's go to the surveillance room.
Thank you, Lomani.
long you been with the company, Lamont?
5 years.
Oh, 5 years. Okay. All the latest gear, huh?
Yep.
You got a family?
Yeah, wife and 2 girls.
Huh. Which ones are the main video drives?
These two.
This one and this one?
Yes.
How old are your girls?
4 and 6.
You got life insurance?
Life insurance.
I'm gonna need to pull these drives.
Jane, this is Frank. He's one of our crisis managers here to get us started internally.
Pleasure. We need to get out in front of this. These things tend to accelerate if we don't. Just a brief interview until the legal team gets here.
Of course.
Thank you.
What a view. That's what the corner office gets you.
Yeah.
I'll try to make this as painless as possible. I need to get a very clear understanding of what it is you've observed.
Of course.
Regulations, you understand.
Okay.
How long have you been with the company?
3 years.
3 years? Mm-hmm. And was Mike your supervisor the entire time?
Yes, but he was more than a supervisor. He was a mentor. Kind of like a big brother.
I can only imagine how difficult this is for you. I'm so sorry. Okay, well, tell me now what you found. Bullet points. We'll get to the specifics later.
Of course. It's not good. Transfers were made to overseas accounts, which were practically untraceable.
Wow, those accounts should have been under the direct governance and control of
someone who has full access and authorization.
Well, there can't be many people on that list. Did you have a name?
I do.
Who is it?
I can't say with absolute certainty.
Who is it?
It's Galt. I've checked all the data thoroughly. He's the only one.
Thaddeus Galt? The man who built the company?
Yes.
This is quite explosive, Jane.
I know. I don't want to take on a man like that. That's why you're here.
That's right. That is why I'm here. But I need to know, have you discussed this with anyone else since making the report? Phoned anyone? Received any phone calls?
Besides Taft, no.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I'm sure.
Do you think that this may have had something to do with your recently departed colleague's demise?
Yes, I think he's who uncovered it.
Interesting.
I'm gonna use the restroom.
Out of the question. We're almost finished here.
Well, I really need to go.
Sit down now. Copies. Yes or no? Did you make any copies? I don't think it would be in your best interest to lie.
Who are you?
Copies. Yes or no? Yes or no?
Yes.
is it?
In my friend's cubicle. I hid it there just in case.
In case of what? Let's go get it.
I'm in the room.
Stop the elevator.
This panel makes no sense whatsoever. We're screwed. She's probably called the cops by now.
I took care of her phone.
Do me a favor. Don't think, all right? Just do what I say.
I'm trying.
Stop the elevator. Entire system's fried.
Damn it!
Mr. Tad, come on, what's going on here?
I'm so sorry, Lamont. I'm sure Mr. Gault will approve all of this.
Frank!
Was that necessary?
You need to get a hold of yourself. We've got a lot to do. Now let's go. We need to get into the elevator room. Turn off this alarm. What about the cops?
It's internal only. They couldn't hear it unless they were parked right outside. We're wasting time.
I need to find one of those elevator keys. Let's go.
Please, does someone hear this?
Do you even know where you're going?
No. Emergency call. Hello? My name is Jane Porter. I'm stuck in the elevator at Galt Tower. Can anybody hear me?
Fixing the situation, not making it worse.
I am fixing the situation. I'm cleaning up your mess.
All right, watch it, Frank. You may be the muscle, but I still run things around here. Don't forget your place.
You're absolutely right.
All right. How do we get her out? Cut the elevator cables.
It won't work. Elevators all have emergency brakes.
All right, well, how about we burn her out?
The sprinkler system will kick on. There's no guarantee she'd die.
Then turn off the sprinklers.
Look, the fire department will be here in 5 minutes, okay? That's no good.
Okay, well, let's hear some of your ideas, because I'm fresh out.
Tell me everything you know about our Jane here. Husband? Boyfriend? Significant other?
A boyfriend, I think. I try not to concern myself with their private lives.
Boyfriend. Do we have his information?
It's in her profile. Everything's on the computer.
A smart girl. It's not over. She's got a lot of fight in her yet.
Open your eyes, Frank. It is over. This girl's gonna be the end of the company and Galt. It's time to split.
We're not going anywhere. Very athletic. Impressive.
that poor guy. He didn't see you coming.
Come on. He did it to himself.
Yo.
Seriously.
Mrs. Ray, I'm not available right now. Leave me a message and I'll get back to you as soon as possible.
Ray! Ray! Ray!
Hey, be patient. She'll be here.
You know, Jane. Her 2 hours always turn to five.
Take it easy, cowboy. Hey, you know she loves you.
No, she loves her job. I'm a close second, though.
Cut her a break.
It's just hard. She doesn't let anybody in.
Let's give her one more hour. If she doesn't show, we'll go and get her.
One more round.
Perfect.
All right, I'm in. Excuse me. Can we get another round, please?
Thank you.
We need to start using our brains here, okay? This thing has spiraled out of control. You gotta start listening to me.
Listening to you?
Yeah. Look, I have access to several accounts that this company holds offshore. Large accounts. Let's cut our losses and let someone else handle this crap. What's wrong?
You.
Oh, great. What's that supposed to mean?
Your lack of loyalty disgusts me.
Now wait, hold it, damn it! Call Galt and tell him what? Okay, no, look, Frank. I'll pay you all my options. The offshore account.
You offer me a bribe?
I could pay you more than Galt ever will. Ever. You know it, and I know it. Look, you could kill me, or you could be $5 million richer.
Wire transfer?
Yes, instant.
This is turning into a witch hunt. Yes. Listen, are you just going to let the SEC continue to investigate these Mickey Mouse allegations? No. All right. I understand. Well, when are you going to get back to the private sector? You know, there's always a position for you here.
Sure. Yeah.
All right. Good night.
Janie, we have an interesting problem. You stuck in that elevator, and me stuck in this building. Stasis. Until something gives.
I don't want to talk to you. Put Taft on.
Mr. Taft is not available right now, but I'd be happy to take a message.
Okay. Put Lamont on.
Lamont's resting.
You monster.
You're about to find out.
Go to hell. What's next, huh? You gonna stare me to death?
I'm trying to remember. It's a thing about a cat. Some guy's name. Schumer's cat. Schlesinger's. It's a paradox. The cat in the box that's both alive and dead. Just like you, Janie.
Well, you think you have me beat? Look where you are.
Savoring the moment.
You're gonna look back and remember this is the night that everything came crashing down.
Maybe.
You and Galt will make great cellmates!
Daddy!
Hey! Oh! Sorry I'm late. I thought that I would never get that elevator running.
Can you stay up late?
Nope. We made a deal. 8 o'clock. Tomorrow night, you can stay up as late as you want for your party.
Would it be a pony ride, like at Hudson's?
No. No smelly animals. Absolutely not.
But Dad said...
Okay, loudmouth. Time for bed.
Tell me you didn't.
Didn't.
I didn't, but you know my dad. He can't say no to the squirt.
Yeah, neither can you. All right. Come on, monster.
Good night, buddy.
Thanks.
Good night. Good night.
Let me know if I should wait up.
Okay.
Come on.
This is Robert.
Towers.
Just returning to inform you that a serviceman has been contacted and should be there shortly.
Thank you very much. Good night.
If you could do something, you'd do it.
Oh, I'm doing something.
You're screwed. But you can't leave because you're just Galt's janitor. That's all you are.
I'm a whole lot more than that. Like your friend Mike found out, he couldn't see the bigger picture. Just like you, Janie. You could have been sitting pretty right now if you played ball. Now, you're just another loose end.
It's a sacrifice for the greater good.
What do you think of that?
I never thought of anybody else.
Janie.
Would I have your word?
That's right. Do this one thing and your family's set for life.
I can't do it.
Let me help you.
Do something. I'm waiting for you.
You hear me?
Do something!
Hey, thanks for coming out so late.
No, it's not a problem. It's part of the job, right? Someone stuck?
Yeah, I got a lady trapped in elevator two. She's freaking out. Can you believe that?
What happened to Lamont? You're wearing his shirt. Oh, geez, he didn't get fired, did he?
Oh, no. He went home sick. And I'm the new guy. And I didn't have any shirts. They didn't have them made up for me, so he let me. Well, he's a nice guy. Frank.
Robert.
Nice to meet you.
Me too. All right, I'll check the machine room. I should probably be able to get it started from there.
Well, you know what? Lamont left sick, and he left in such a hurry that he never gave me those keys.
How am I supposed to reboot the system?
Well, can't you just get on top of the elevator, take her out through the emergency hatch?
It's against regulations. Extracting passengers through the hatch is strictly last resort.
My job's kind of on the line here.
Your job?
Yeah, it's my first day. I got this hotshot exec yelling about how she's gonna get me fired because I can't get her out. I've been on unemployment for a year. I got a wife and kids. I need this job, please. One time. Please.
Okay. Hey. Frank. If anyone asks, I tried to fix the problem downstairs first, okay?
Absolutely, 100%. Something wrong?
Oh, no. It's just my wife saying goodnight.
Well, the sooner we get down here, the sooner you get home to her, right?
Yeah. Amen to that. Did you open the doors already, Frank?
I did, and I was just trying to get her out, you know, and I guess you need some kind of special tool for that bolt or something.
Yeah, there's a very good reason for that. It's so that untrained people like yourself don't get yourself killed. Elevators are the safest form of transportation, and that's an actual fact. But that doesn't mean they won't squish you real good if you get unlucky. Believe me, too many people do. I have seen some things. Anyway, in the future, when you have a problem with an elevator,
that's good advice. Thanks.
Hello?
Help!
Oh, hey, you know what? Don't get her stirred up again. I finally got her calmed down, and she was kind of flipping out. You know, she got it in her head. I was trying to hurt her. Can you believe that?
I've seen it before. No problem. People, when they get in enclosed spaces, sometimes they get a little crazy. I'll just get her out. Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. What are you doing?
Well, I'm just going to help you.
Yeah, don't. This is what I do, Frank. Hey, when you get a license to fix elevators, you can play around in the shafts all you like. But until then, just, you know, give me a break.
Help! Please, get me out of here!
Come on, please. You gotta get me out of here fast.
She's totally lost it.
Just take it easy, lady. It's okay. I'm gonna...
We'll have you out in just a second, all right?
No! Get me out of here now, please! I'm gonna go crazy in here, please.
Shot you, ma'am?
Yes, he shot me. I have the gun in here.
Okay, just relax, ma'am. Nobody's trying to kill you. I promise. I'm gonna have you out of there in just a second if you just...
Something wrong?
Robert?
Looks like there's like a bunch of dirt or something caked in here.
Get me out now!
Oh, yeah. I'll have you out in a second. I'm gonna have to grab a screwdriver or something.
No. No! No! No!
You're a terrible liar.
Huh? Calm down. Calm down. Stop. Calm down. I'm not gonna hurt you.
Oh my God. I'm sorry. Are you okay?
Yeah. I'm assuming, since I'm still breathing, that gun is not loaded.
No. Is he still out there?
Yeah, what the hell is going on?
No, he's still out there. Here. Did I call you?
No. He just did what everybody does when someone is stuck in an elevator. You know, they call a repairman. Oh, Wait, you are shot.
Yeah, but I'm okay. Listen, we need to get out of here before he comes back. Listen to me. Where does that ladder go?
It goes to the roof, but just relax. I closed the outer doors. He can't even get into the shaft.
He did before.
Yeah, but before, he had this. It's the building's elevator key. He can't get into the elevators without it. This is the safest place. And in an hour, when my wife starts to wonder what's happened, she'll call someone.
Can't he just get another key?
No, there is no other key. Not in this building, anyway.
How can you be sure of that?
Take a look.
What, Robert Brown? You're Robert Brown?
Well, Robert Brown Jr. I work for my dad. You are?
Jane Porter.
Well, it's nothing personal, Jane Porter, but it has not been my pleasure to meet you.
So he's not getting in here?
No.
You promise?
I promise. Pack a mean wallet, by the way.
Sorry. Couldn't you just get a key from another building?
Uh-uh. Not all buildings have the same elevator key. What's he gonna do, break into everyone on the block and risk more witnesses? I don't think so.
Drink up.
She'll be here.
It's getting pretty late. I better go get her.
I will bet you $1 million that we are both going to be fine.
$1 million. Elevator repair business must be booming.
Yeah, it's pretty good. It's honest work and it's steady. My wife and I have a beautiful house. We put a little money aside for our kid to go to college. And what more does a man want, right?
You're right. You really are.
Yeah. I see people just chasing more, you know, more stuff, more money, more power. Never satisfied. Those people are more stuck than we are right now.
Thank you, Mr. Robert Brown Jr.
What for?
For rescuing me, of course.
Well, we're not out of this box yet, but yeah, we're gonna be fine. In fact, I would bet that guy is probably 1 million miles away by now, just from whatever.
3, 4, 1, 8, 2.
What? What did he say?
3, 4, 1, 8, 2. Ramble Hills Drive. You hear me, repairman?
Robert, what's wrong?
You say you fix elevators. Well, I'm in a different line of work.
If you hurt my family, I will kill you. Do you understand? I will kill you.
You have 60 seconds to open this door, or I'm going to go down to Ramble Hills Drive and introduce myself to your family. They'll get to see up close better than I do. Your wife's kind of hot. I may have a look. 60 seconds and counting, Robert. 45 seconds, repairman. You care about a stranger more than your family?
point! Let me go! Let me go!
No!
This is my thing. He wants me.
I'm not leaving the lives of my family to you or anybody else. Now help me up!
Okay.
Help me!
Come on! Okay. Okay, you got this.
15 seconds!
I need to borrow your key cards. All right, hold on.
You're quick on your feet.
All right, here.
Jane always said that.
I got it. Come on.
Trouble, but not anymore.
Take the elevator down to the garage.
Why?
Ray? It's been a long night. I just want to go home.
Going down.
Baby, are you okay? Huh?
Yeah.
What's happening? What?
Don't worry, I'm okay.
Oh my God, what happened to you? What? What happened to you, baby? Oh my God.
I'll tell you everything. Can we go home, please?
Yes. Yeah. Okay. Oh, baby.
Oh. I love you.
Your vitals all look really good.
That's good.
Comfortable?
All things considered. Yeah, when do you think's the earliest I'll be able to get out of here?
I'm gonna keep you overnight, and if you're feeling well, I'll probably get you to work by Monday.
Babe.
Hi.
I'm so glad you're okay.
I'm good. I'm okay. I love you.
Hey.
Hey.
What happened?
What's up, man? How you doing?
Good.
Happy birthday.
Thank you.
Jane, oh. There was a woman on the elevator with me named Jane.
Yeah, she called and checked on you.
Is she okay?
She's gonna be fine. I'll be back to check on you in a little bit.
Surprised to see me? Pleasantly so, I hope.
No. I knew I'd see you again. I just thought you'd be in handcuffs.
Well, Jane, you know how these things work. By the way, I've ordered a complete and thorough investigation into this whole sorry affair.
Don't insult me, Mr. Galt. I know what you've done, and I'm not gonna let you get away with it.
Jane, please, don't be foolish. Pick your bets very carefully. You know, a wise man once said, he who controls the nation's money supply cares not who makes its laws.
You're going to jail.
And if I don't, do you think I'm gonna forget about you?
I don't think you or I can afford to forget about one another.
It's such a shame. You know, power would have sat so beautifully on those elegant shoulders of yours. You would have been a strong, extraordinary leader in business. But as it is, you've got no sense of humor.
Did you ever consider that maybe you're not funny, sir?
Say hi to Walt for me.
Wake up this morning, has just begun.
Ready to leave this all behind?
Everything I need is right here.
Daddy's Dog appeared before the Securities and Exchange Commission today to answer charges of fraud and embezzlement.
If found guilty as CEO of Gull Capital, he could be facing up to 20 years in prison. There is also an ongoing investigation into the suspicious and untimely death of one of Gull Capital's financials.
Can be disguised with cliffs under.